Good morning, boys and girls. It's Miss Sands, and I am showing you into another part of my house today. Today, you are getting a sneak peek in my room where I sleep. This is where I sleep. And on the wall behind me are some of my favorite pictures and prints. And so I thought I would give you a tour. So far, we've been in Charlie's room and Kennedy's room and outside and in my dining room. And today you're getting a peek into my room. I wish I could see your room to see what all neat treasures you have in there. But behind me, you can see a few of mine. I love to collect prints that are just special to me. So anyway, this is a peek into my room. All right, today in science, we're going to keep talking about space. Yesterday, we started our unit and we were talking about Earth. Well, today we're going to talk about atmosphere and space. And I want to kind of give you a little introduction into that unit. So can anybody tell me what these might be? Yes, if you said rain boots. These are my rain boots. And boys and girls, you know that when it is raining, I wear these a lot in the winter, or when it's snowy, I put these on because these boots are useful to keep my feet from getting wet. They have this good sole on the bottom, and this keeps my feet from getting wet. Rain boots are made of special material like this that stop water from coming into my boots. I also have a pair of tennis shoes, which I can't show you right now, but I do have these. Hold on. I have these bedroom shoes, and if I were to wear these out in the rain, they would not keep my feet wet because of the material that they're made of. Well, similarly, God designed the earth with a sky and an atmosphere to protect it. And so today in science, you're going to read about how the atmosphere is like my boots. And then at the end of your science reading time, I want you to read in the Bible, in Genesis, at creation, to see how God created the atmosphere. So you're going to read 2 pages in your science book, and then you're going to read 2 verses in Genesis. And it's laid out for you on the lesson plan for today. Okay, so that's science, and we're just going to keep moving through space this week and after Easter break. All right, today in Bible, we are going to be, I've got to get all my little treasures over here to look at. All right, today in Bible, yesterday our takeaway was I have to decide what to do with Jesus. And we have to make a decision. Are we going to accept Jesus for who he is and who he says he is, or are we going to kind of wash our hands like Pilate and are we going to walk away from him? Either way, we're making a decision. And so that was what we talked about yesterday. Today, we're going to have 2 takeaways because I really want to get through the whole story before we go on break. And so today, our 2 takeaways are going to be Jesus knew he would suffer in order to save us, and nothing is too hard for Jesus. So we're going to learn those 2 takeaways in our Bible lesson today. And then in math, we're going to keep talking about money. Today, we're going to talk about quarters and I think dimes. None of this is new. We've done this earlier in the year. It's just practice again. So you're going to be counting on. So if you have a quarter, which is 25, and then a dime, you're going to write 25 plus the dime amount would be 35. Okay, so we're going to count on. We're not going to label the coins. We're going to count on however many it tells us to. And then there's some parts where you have to buy things. So you've got to say, okay, how much money do I have here? I have a quarter and 3 dimes. Well, that would be 25, 35, 45, 55. And if I know these shoes cost 52 cents, am I going to have enough money to buy them? Yes, because I have 55 and the shoes are 52. So you're going to have some problems like that today in math. There is not going to be any IXL today. Let's see. In language, you are going to complete this language sheet, page 101 and 102. You're going to write these words in ABC order here, and these words in ABC order here, and then write 1 sentence from choosing one of the words up here. So you could write a sentence using duck or a sentence using cheese. Pick 1 word to write a sentence down here. And on the back, you're just writing these sentences correctly. You're going to write this sentence correctly, and this sentence correctly, and this sentence correctly, making sure you have capital letters and punctuation at the end, okay? All right, so that's writing today, and then I want you to free write. You don't have to send me a picture of that, but I just want you to spend 10 minutes writing. You can write a letter. You could write a card. You could write a list of something maybe that you have to do. You can write a story. You can tell me how to do something, but you can do free write for whatever you want to write about, okay? And then spelling, you just have page 158 in your book and to study for your test, which will be tomorrow. Okay, so I think that's all that I need to tell you. Oh, my eyes are burning. Oh, I think that's all that I need to tell you about for today for your work. I'm really proud of the work that you're turning in, boys and girls. I'm so proud of you. I miss you so much. I wish we were together right now just to spend our days together, but also in this time of year where we're talking about Jesus and just the sacrifice and that he did on my behalf and the gift that he has given us in the death on the cross and the resurrection. All of that is such a gift for us, and I wish we could be together to talk about that and to just really think about it and to enjoy and to just be grateful for what God has done. But the good thing is that we can be just as grateful at home with our families as we could be if we were together. And so I want you to know that I miss you. I'm super proud of you. I hope that you learn a lot today about the atmosphere and space and putting sentences together and about Jesus's creation. I hope you learn about all that today. Boys and girls, know that I love you and I look forward to seeing you soon. Peace out.